Gavin, it's great to have you here. I know all about your career and stuff outside the walls of DkIT, but for people watching, explain what it is you do when you're not here studying in Dundalk Institute of Technology.
Thanks very much for having me here anyway. But no, yes, just a quick explanation of what I do. I suppose I've been working on myself and my career, the music industry, I suppose I've been involved in there the last couple of years, but I've been kind of more involved in the country and folk industry. And in a certain sense, I've kind of, this last couple of years, I've kind of grown up nearly with that kind of resurgence that's come in the industry. And I found then that with that, whenever I'm doing my own gigs and things as well, between giving gigs and doing bits of recording and all things like that there, it's definitely seen a big kind of increase in numbers, and it's become a lot more popular in the last couple of years as well. So yeah, what I kind of do normally is during the weekends and probably sometimes midweek as well now, I could be travelling from the top end of Ireland to the very bottom and even further afield, England, Scotland and even Spain now, actually coming up this year as well. So yeah, so I'd be doing different gigs and performing sort of all around. So thankfully it's going from strength to strength. So we'll see how it goes.
Good. And why did you decide on DkIT? What could DkIT teach you?
Well, the biggest thing for me was I needed somewhere where I could still work on myself and work on my career. And at the same time, I wanted to further my education. So for what I was looking to do was I wanted to stay at home where I had everything I needed at home. If I needed to go to a gig or I needed to do a wedding, whatever it may be, at least I could do that. And that option was available to me, but it meant I could still travel every day and do my education and still progress in that sense. And thankfully now I'm a third year into the course, so it seems to be going well now. So hopefully finish it off now and see where we go after that.
Exactly. So like, I've seen you perform and you are genuinely, not just because you're here right now and there's a load of cameras around, you are absolutely fantastic.
Thank you very much.
What has studying music here actually taught you?
I suppose the kind of performance element of it was something that I kind of maybe
already had.
Well, it was something I was doing beforehand. I've been doing different fashions and things like that since I was in talent competitions and all that since I was really young. And actually back in 2016, probably the one of the biggest highlights of my career so far was I won the All-Ireland score. So it was in the ANEC Killarney. But there's different things that kind of have motivated me, I suppose. But even last year I was doing a festival actually in Meath, and it was probably one of the biggest highlights of my career so far. But it was that festival, I think, in the whole day it was about 60,000 people.
Wow.
So yeah, so it was a big day and it was a very good opportunity for me. So the likes of that kind of performance element of things, I suppose I was fortunate enough to be kind of half used to it. I was enjoying the process of that, but in terms of what I've learned in here, I really enjoyed the kind of actually learn the theory so I could apply that in practice. Or even there's different things, the composing end of things was maybe something I wouldn't have been doing an awful lot of outside of education, so I thought it would be beneficial, and it has been beneficial for doing different things outside of a class as well.
Right. You said there was a festival you performed at in Meath with 60,000 people.
Mm.
What festival was that?
Vinalti. Steam Progression Festival.
Amazing.
Yeah, so thankfully now last year and actually this year as well, I'm back on that festival again, and there's a few other festivals I'm doing this year. So I'm in the Wild West Music Fest as well. So there's different things that thankfully are progressing now this year. So we'll see where it takes us.
So we know what lies ahead this year for Gavin Gribben. What lies ahead? What's the dream?
Well, I suppose at the minute, actually, very recently, they released my new video for my latest single, The Pub Crawl. So the video has
been... Pub Crawl, I love that.
So if you don't make it home, you'll be there in the morning. And if you don't make it home, you'll be there tomorrow.
Now. Any of them doing it, DkIT can tell you that one.
But so I released the video for it. And thankfully, it's going very, very well. I'm very happy with the response. And there's so many messages coming in as well. So I'm really... Thank you very much to everybody who has either seen it and shared it and all the rest as well. But it has things like that there, hopefully progress and hopefully release a few more singles, maybe an album, and we'll see where things take us as well. If I could maybe get into the scene where I'm doing it full time, I'd absolutely love that.
Yeah, that would be the dream.
That would be the
dream. As for right now, to be able to be studying and travelling to, what you were saying, all around Ireland obviously, but England, Scotland, Wales, going to Spain as well, that's pretty cool. That's not a bad life.
No, it's hectic, I will say that. Between everything now, it's a lot of long days and short nights, I suppose.
A lot of Ryanair flights.
Yeah, mm. Well, that's it. You go, there you go. But yeah, no, it is. It's a case of maybe there's been a lot of nights where I've been maybe going to bed at 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning and you're up at 5:30 away on the road again back to uni. Like, but I suppose you get into kind of a way of doing it that if it works, you know, any opportunity that you can maybe take a wee bit of relaxing, you do it, or you any kind of thing where you think you might be able to take a back step. In certain instances where it works, you definitely take it, you know what I mean? And you learn to adjust, I suppose.
Yeah, of course. I've seen you perform. I'm really excited to see you perform again. Gavin, it's been great chatting to you, and best of luck with everything.
Appreciate it. Thank you very much for having me on today.
Problem.
Thank you.
I have been, but there's only one to fill my dreams, a place that lingers in my mind is a town I've left behind. I've been away now for too many years. I've read all the papers, they've told of your tears, and so I've left you with a heart that's been torn. I'm going home now to the place I was born. That's Belfast you called to me when I am far away. I think of thee, your black mountain, Cave Hill, City Hall, Shaw's Bridge, River Lagan. I'm going home to the mall. I've met friends and relations, each one I'll embrace. We'll pass round the pictures that time can't erase, and it won't be long now till I see them all, and we'll walk down the aisle streets, and good times I recall. That's Belfast you call to me when I am far away. I think of thee, your black mountain, Cave Hill, City Hall, Shaw's Bridge, River Lagan. I'm going home to the mall. Shaw's Bridge, River Lagan. I'm going home to the mall.